I need to know how to fix furnace ignition failure.
Whether you have a gas furnace or electric furnace, make sure the power is on.
The power being on shouldn't affect a gas furnace.
Even gas furnaces need electricity for the control panel and the furnace ignition, unless you've got one that actually has an old-fashioned pilot light.
All gas furnaces have a pilot light.
Even 2-decade-old oil furnaces use a transformer to ignite the fuel, and modern gas furnaces usually have an electric ignition.
How do I get mine to light up?
Make sure the circuit breaker and fuse for the furnace aren't off, though if the control panel is blinking incoherently, turn it off at the breaker and back on.
That's a hard reboot.
The downside of new smart HVAC equipment is that their systems are like mini PCs, even to the point of needing a reboot to resolve errors caused by outages or brownouts.
I do not think my furnace's problem is due to the power supply.
Ignition switches last an average of 4 years, but a furnace that is cycling due to overheating or a dirty flame sensor will wear it out faster.
So I need to replace the ignition switch.
That's possible. It could have been damaged when you cleaned the flame sensor.
I have a repair person do that.
The dirt in the system because of a dirty air filter or bad combustion in a gas furnace could cause it to go bad.
That's a new reason to clean out the furnace.
Replacing a pressure switch and hot surface ignition switch can be done as a do-it-yourself project, but if it is the control board, you'll want to call a pro.
If I had a gas furnace, would cleaning the burner help?
Cleaning the burner might help it ignite, and replacing it could fix the problem if the supply valve is stuck shut, causing the ignition to refuse to go.
This is getting to be more complicated than the good old days of climbing down to the basement with a match to light the burner.
There are induced rafter furnaces that have an intermittent pilot light that ignites the main burner when the flame sensing rod recognizes it.
And if that flame sensing rod is dirty or broken, the unit won't ignite. What about the HSI?
The heat sensor ignition can fail because you touched it too much and got oil on it or cracked it. The house voltage got too high or a dirty air filter caused the high temperature limit switch to kick in.
Given all the safety features that can kill the ignition, it is a wonder it burns at all.